Hello and welcome to this short Mocha Explainer video with me, Ben Brownlee from Boris FX. And over the next few minutes, we're going to be looking at two of the most important concepts to help make your tracking better in Mocha. So join me in my Mocha Coplanar Explainer. One of the huge strengths of the Mocha tracker is being able to draw almost any shape or several shapes on an area you want to track. As long as these shapes defines a coplanar surface, you'll often get a perfect track without even thinking too hard about it. This can lead people to believe two things. One, Mocha is magic. And two, I can track anything, always, without ever having to think about it. The first one is arguable. The second one is unfortunately wrong. I just threw out a couple of words that need a bit more focus. Coplanar and surface. Coplanar. This is a huge concept when working in Mocha, as Mocha is a planar tracker. If objects are coplanar, it means that they lie on the same geometric plane. Let's take this shape and add a few dots onto it. It's probably worth noting here that Mocha doesn't track dots like a point tracker would. It's just easier to show dots when talking about geometry without getting distracted. If we take a look at these dots and I move around, you can see that they share a geometric plane. They have a common relationship, that is, coplanar. If we look instead at these dots, and I move around them now, these do not have that same shared type of movement. They aren't all sitting on the same plane. They are non-coplanar. Here we can see multiple geometric planes. Let's add in the planes themselves. And what could this scene be? Well, of course. The important thing about choosing which shapes to track with the Mocha tracker is to make sure the contents are coplanar, otherwise the track quality will suffer. We're not interested in individual points. Mocha is not a point tracker or even a cloud point tracker. We're interested in the texture in that shape. The shape is good. It defines a single plane. This one is not good, as the movement of this texture goes over several planes. Tracking this will give you an inaccurate track. I can even define a plane with several shapes. As long as these are all coplanar, Mocha will be happy and you'll be happy too. I can even add in a little extra edge to my shapes. Mocha won't mind, and it could even aid in getting a better track. The surface is probably one of the most important things to understand in all of Mocha. It's both an important concept and a practical one when you have to export and use your data. I've got my media here and have a shape over an area that has coplanar elements. It sits on a geometric plane. I'm going to quickly track this through. And if we look at the shape, it appears to be a good, solid track. But how do we know? That's a job for the surface. And we view the surface by turning on this blue button here, or here, if you're working in the Essentials workspace. The surface is our representation of the planar surface attached to this layer. Its initial shape is determined by the first shape we draw on this layer, but we can move it around without worrying about changing or breaking anything, because the surface has no keyframes. Its movement is entirely based on the tracking data we have created for this layer. Let me say that again. The surface has no keyframes. If its movement is wrong, it means your tracking data isn't good enough, and you should fix your track. We can set the surface up on the plane we want to track before we hit the track button, and this lets us see exactly how good the data is whilst we're tracking it through. We can always tweak the exact position of the points up afterwards if we want or need to. Alternatively, we can leave the surface off completely until after we have tracked, and just use it to identify any problem areas or check that our track is sticking. The surface also has a practical aspect beyond just checking the track quality. When outputting tracking data to any of the applications that Mocha can supply tracking data to, the points on our surface are the points that get exported. For corner pin or perspective tracking, you get the four corner points. For simple transform data, you'll also get a center point derived from the middle of those four points. Now remember, that the surface isn't the tracking data. The tracking data sits safely hidden away and only changes when we retrack our shape The Surface sits on top of the tracking data. This makes it easy to use the Surface to create what would be called offset track data in a traditional point tracker world. So we track one thing that's easy to track and simply slide our Surface over to an area that would be tricky to track. This is made more powerful, of course, by the fact that we can easily move the Surface to any coplanar area. I can move it here, it still fits. This flexibility and separation between tracking data and the layer and shape data lets us do some more advanced tracking techniques, such as unlinked tracking or pre-keyframing our shape before tracking. It also makes it a snap to recycle tracking data for multiple purposes, or to do some powerful paintwork with techniques such as stabilize, destabilize, or align surface tracks. But these techniques are beyond the scope of this video and have tutorials all of their own. Now, there are a couple of exceptions to the rules, because there always are. I said the surface itself has no keyframes. That's true, except when using manual tracking, or if you've used the adjust track module to manually add keyframes to tweak the surface. Neither of these should be common practice with the vast majority of shots you will tackle. There are almost always better ways to fix a track by simply adjusting your settings and retracking that area.
The most important things to remember are these. Mocha is a planar tracker, so to get the best tracks, choose shapes that have coplanar movement. And the surface is the representation of that planar data, so we can use it to either check or test the quality of our track. And we can also use it to determine where we take that track data from by aligning our surface to our area of interest. We're always in complete control, and that's the power of Mocha.
Thanks again for joining me. If you'd like to see more of this type of video, or you have something else you want to learn about, then please leave a comment below. To download Mocha or see all of our other training, then head on over to borisfx.com.